Alright, welcome or welcome back, new viewers and game viewers. It is time for the 300 sub special, and the viewers have chosen in the previous sub special that we do Pokemon Sword and Shield Dynamax Adventures. Well, mind you, do keep in mind I haven't touched this game since Scarlet and Violet came out, so I may be a little rusty with Dynamax mechanics. Hey, Nolan, why don't we do what we used to do before Scarlet and Violet came out and try to shiny hunt Rayquaza again to start off this wondrous sub special? And if you happen to be on YouTube, do not hesitate to join. Oh, not YouTube, Twitch. Do not hesitate to join along with me. And for those of you on YouTube, hey, if you want to see this again, do let us know. Anyways, let us get to the sub special, and hey, we're ready for battle instantly. Pretty fast loading. It's nice to know that even after Scarlet and Violet came out, there's still people playing this game. Alright, let's see what I kind of want to go for Flygon. If they don't, yeah, of course. It's the best option there. Alright, if he doesn't choose Armaldo, I want to go for it. Probably the best option here as well. Nope, of course. Take all the best options, man. Just leave me with scraps like Pukamuku. Man, am I glad that thing ain't in Sword and Shield. That's Scarlet Violet. SV. I guess I'm going Drodigan. It doesn't even have a goddamn Dragon-type move. I should have went Sudowoodo. Oops. Alright, normal poison. Psychic, electric, flying. Flying is a strong flying type up there. Gloom. I don't know what that normal type is, and honestly, I don't think I want to know. It's gonna be so weird doing Dynamax raids again instead of Terror raids. And oh man. Alright, we got the Gloom. Alright, Drodigan, let's do it. Man, Drodigan's another mon that really should get an evolution. Again, if Duraludon of all things could get an evolution, as of this video coming out, Indigo Disc hasn't come out yet, but still, then I think Drodigan could get an evolution. I mean, people don't seem to like his design, and it definitely is the weakest dragon type in Generation 5, but it's still cool, man. Y'all underestimate this thing. It just needs a little more attention is all. Max Ooze, try to raise your own special attack. And it missed, uh-huh. Yeah, let's do this again. Dual Wing beats again. I was about to say it's powered up by sheer force, no it isn't. I think Iron Head's the only move in its things we've said seem affected by that. You may have learned many other moves that could take advantage of that, but no, let's just ignore that. Oh, you're so scary, Armaldo. Man, ever since Kluivor came around, Armaldo's kind of been shafted to the side. Has better utility, it has a much higher attack stat, better coverage, even if it doesn't learn any water type moves like Armaldo can. I don't know. Alright, nice meaty bug-type hit there. Can I get my flying-type move off is the question. Ha, get rid of that special attack buff, we don't need it. No, Blossom! Yeah, had he not done that, Blossom would be dead and we'd be one, down one, whatchamacallit. One stat. One life. Alright, one more hit, is the Blossom gonna attack? If it didn't already. Nah, it doesn't matter. Eh, Lash, I'll just click something. Alright, Dargain Claw. Alright, no need to catch this. Oh, wait. Ah, blast, I forgot. That catching these actually raises your chance of getting a shiny. Oh, well. And I don't care about it. I'm gonna stick with Drodigan until we get something better. Alright, you want that instead of Armaldo? Whatever, it's your choice, dude. I don't think that's the best choice, but hey, it's his choice. Alright, Electric, that looks like a Stunfisk, and Wailmer. Ah, Wailmer. Man, I miss my buddy Whalmer when I was doing up in Galar, not in Paldea, because Dondozo exists. Dondozo is essentially just, a lot of people like to say, and I said it before in my playthrough, it's basically, I like to call it Paldean Whiskash. I mean, just look at it. Instead of the ground type. I was talking to somebody before about how this is a really baffling design decision, in my opinion. Whalmer is one of the caveats of that, if you will, or one of the whatever the word I'm looking for, the candidates of it, caveats of it. I don't know how Pokemon with high HP stats tend to have really low defense stats, or vice versa, really low defense stats but high HP stats. And I don't know about you, but that's so baffling to me. If it's supposed to be tanky, why give it low one or the other, but then high one or the other? Like, Wailord is an example of that, Dusclops is an example of that, Dusknoir. I mean, it's one thing when you get something like Chansey where it has high HP, but then really high special defenses as well. And its defense stats are garbage, because hey, it can take one attack on one, it can take one of the defenses, even if it's complete garbage in one defense, it's super good in the other, so it makes sense. It does what it needs to do decently well. I think I should let the Flygon Dynamax, so I'm gonna leave that alone. And I just keep trying to dual Wingreed. Either that or maybe the Blossom, I don't know. Max Steel Strike, jeez. Off of what Steel Technique? Probably Heavy Slam, that would make sense. Alright, Giga Drain. Alright, and Moonblast Dome goes the Whalmer. And catching this just for a higher chance to get it at 777. Not too bad. Maybe I'll go buy some Ultra Balls off screen or something, I don't know. I don't want to change it, so I'm good without it. Oh, Steel Roller, that's the Steel type move it had. We have either one in Scarlet or Violet, Terra Steel. For them pesky grass types, at least to resist our attack. Alright, what's up here? Yeah, let's go after the Machoke, I want an item. Hey, everybody else seemed to have thought the same thing. You encountered a backpacker. I can share my supplies with you if you need. Didn't even let me finish, I'm taking the Life Orb. I want to do some damage, and Life Orb pairs very well with Sheer Force, so that's good. If you didn't already know, which I'm pretty sure most Poke fans know, that if Life Orb is used in conjunction with Sheer Force, and you're using an item that's... A move that's affected by Sheer Force, you don't have to worry about Life Orb's HP recoil, which is really busted, but you still get the boost from it. All reward and no risk, I'm loving that. So every move essentially becomes like a 67% boost or something. It's pretty devastating. That'll do a wing beat isn't one of those. And that's why you don't use high HP low defense Pokemon, dude. Or what other Pokemon suffer from that? Shuckle especially is the biggest example. Bastiodon, at least for Wobbuffet, it makes sense why it has huge HP below defenses, to maximize the amount of damage you can get off of things like Mirror Code and Counter. So at least in that case, that design decision definitely makes sense in my opinion. But for most others, not really. I just dual wing beat them suckers. Yes, make his moves miss, assuming he doesn't use a max move. Our Dazzlingly. Good, my dual wing beat should take it out from that range. One. A two. Get off my screen. Why did I do that? I forgot again. Whatever, too late. It does have a rock type move, but requires having flying type moves. No, I don't think it's the best thing. Best case scenario, whatever. Alright, and now it's time. And I bet everybody missed me saying this. Rayquaza, I've come to bargain. Not gonna lie, it feels pretty decent to say that right now. Look at this man. He better be shiny after this. And too bad I don't have a Dragon type move to use against him. Or anything super effective for that matter, so I'm gonna just try to, well, he's a Dynamax one, they're immune to flinching. Actually, it doesn't matter because I have Sheer Force. What am I saying? Alright, we didn't lose a single life, so we got a good chance against this, especially since Rayquaza is pretty easy compared to most of the other Dynamax mons. Sonic Guard. Hey, crit, clutch. That's gonna hurt me bad. Oh, and Twister's a spread move, too. I think he used coaching a little late there, dude. It pairs well with my stats, thankfully, so that's not half bad. And suddenly I miss using Heal Cheers and Terror Raids. Did I flinch? Okay, good. Yeah, I'm not terrestrializing. I'm not Dynamaxing with that low of HP, sadly, so I'm just gonna leave that alone. Alright, Dark and Claw does some boosted damage. He's already at half HP, looking good. Don't max strike me. Alright, got the Machoke. I think Machoke will win that. No, it didn't. Okay, I was wrong. I was a wrong man. A wrong Jong. Passive healing, my favorite. Yeah, pair that up well. If I had a leftovers, that would work really good. As long as it doesn't attack me, I could probably last a bit longer. Hopefully the Flygon trainer is the one who gets the Dynamax. Alright, Iron Head again. That's all I really can do. Heal. Okay. A reflex going up, not very helpful. I fly gone, yeah, now we're meeting business here. Lower his attack. Oh no, my stat buffs, man. Why would you do that? Honestly, here's a lot less annoying than it is in Scarlet and Violet. And he, of course he did. Thanks for the spread boot, jackass. I'm dead here, man. Alright, Wormwind, do it! Hit him hard! Alright, lowering that attack stat. And my Iron Head will probably not kill, but that's fine. Oh, and I'm dead. This doesn't matter. Alright, hopefully my cheers are good enough for us to catch this thing. And see if it is shiny. Cheer him on. And And down goes the Razaquias. Alright, and where's my Ultra Ball? Get in here. Oh, we already know it's gonna catch, so I don't know why I'm even anticipating it not catching, or why it even shakes multiple times like that. Just shake once and go. Saves a bit of time, and a little bit of animation too. Probably the animation budget as well. Alright, no shiny? Eh, sad. Big sad. I cannot take you home with me, Razaquias. Yes, record it. Alright, let's do this again. Alright, whilst we wait for people to come in, and wow. That name. Okay, then. Double Alex and then Milk Bitch. I gotta say it. Just had to say it. And then Tobias. He came back with his almighty Darkrai, even though Darkrai ain't in this game. He's in Scarlet and Violet now, man. Just go to Paldea. You're good. Still no Latios, though. And whatever else you might have. Nah, let's just go. Alright, now what do we have available? I get the second option, thankfully. Alright, I'm not choosing Lorantis. Yeah, let's do Weezing. Weaken those pesky Dragon-type moves. The one time Misty Terrain actually ends up being decently useful. A strong Dragon tap this time. I guess it's just random if it refers to it as one type or the other type if it's dual-typed. Yeah, I'm going after the grass type, let's see what that is. Ah, wait, we have two mons and a steam weak to grass. Though we have two that resist it, so not the worst. It balances out, right? Okay. And that's not a gloom. No, it's a gloom. And now it's not weak to poison, great. Why so gloom, chum? Okay. Alright, at least we don't have to worry about getting poisoned or any stun spores. We don't gotta worry about none of that. And I do get flamethrower. Alright, yeah, no taunt. Just go straight for the flamethrower. A critical hit. Alright, lowering speed, even though we're all faster than that, at least I think so. What if I said one of the terrains, like, protected you from stat drops? That would have been cool. But alas, that is not the case. Max Starfall! Nothing. No damage at all. I ain't Dynamax, and we don't need to. And the icy wind kills. Alright, I ain't choosing Gloom, we sticking with good old Weezing. I remember back when Pokemon X and Y were coming out, there were somehow leaks about Weezing potentially getting an evolution. Kinda glad that didn't happen, and they went for a regional variant instead. Honestly, maybe the better case scenario. Just saying, because then they'd have to give Arbok an evolution too. Which Arbok definitely would benefit from one. Good without it. Alright, we got a Grim Sneerable Boy or an Obstadoon. Yeah, let's get an item while we're here. Oh, of course not. Okay. Thankfully, I have an advantage against it. You gotta have your type advantages, you gotta know them too. Yeah, it's just Pokemon Basics. I don't know why I'm saying that. It's Gigantamax as well. Actually, I can hit it with a stab fairy type move as well, because fairy does not resist itself. So, and it's much stronger than Clear Smog, so let's do it. And Jellystent is big again. Just be careful of those dark type moves. Did that miss? Of course it did. Ah, grand. Now we're all gonna get put to sleep. Why are you attacking me with that, huh? Oh, never mind. I keep forgetting. The field effect does not allow for such things to happen. It's kind of funny how I'm the fastest thing here as well. Alright, let's try that again. Hopefully you don't miss this time. Nobody likes missing, you know. There we go. Sizable damage. Decent, decent. We good. You're trying to put us to sleep, it won't work. And stop attacking. What? Jeez, he keeps attacking me for. For what? I don't know what I did. And just something with some accuracy, Clear Smeg. The move that nobody uses. Ah, that's not true. That's fine. On Gloom. And you're dead. Alright, there's two mons down. One more to go before the big Rickway again. And because you don't have access to a decent fairy type move, I'm afraid I'd have to put you to the side. We got a normal type over here, Azumarill. It's hard to tell what. I think that's that's Mudsdale. All right, I want an item, so let's go this way. That's double. All right, if I was Fluffy, we could flamethrower it. All right, what do we have? I think a Misty Seeds might have to be the thing I'll use. Yeah, Misty Seeds. Screw it. Pairs well with my ability, so why not?
Oh.
I always come forth. Misty Surge. Alright, Flamethrower, just on the off chance that you do have Fluffy and not... I forgot what other ability it gets. I think it's Fluffy, though. He's Dynamaxing the Laurentice. Alright, that didn't do anything. You know, if Double does come back in the Scarlet Violet DLC, it probably won't. But if it did, Terra Fighting Body Press would be pretty good. Terra Fighting Cotton Guard Body Press. Sounds like a halfway decent strat to me. And judging by the damage, it does look like this thing has, does have Fluffy. Alright, Max Strike. Lower that speed and make it a little easier to hit. I kinda miss Power Punch. I wish that move would come back in Scarlet Violet. One of my favorite moves. Alright, Max Overgrowth. Get a Grassy Terrain. Wait, I missed you Terrain and you just gave him priority Grassy Glide. Not like it matters too much, but still. At least I get a little healing off. Not bad. No, bad. Activated his trap card. Alright, next this turn you're pretty much done for. Alright, down goes the double. The Dubsta. Alright, and now we get the bigger prize. Rayquaza. No, wait, fuck. Oh, well. Oh, wait, he's taking it first. Okay, good. You motherfuck this game. Okay. Oh, well, I made a little mistake there. Ah, doesn't matter. Now, there goes weakening the Dragon-type moves, but whatevs. I'm really surprised there isn't an ability that is just like Airlock, but for terrains. Really does make me wonder why that's the case. Alright, already used up your move, that's cool. Substitution, because your attacks won't be able to do much to me. I don't have to worry too much. And we just Mega Kick until the cows come home, I suppose. Till the miltanks come home, excuse me. I can D-max if I truly want to, but I got my substitute. Why would I need that? Yeah, kick him right in his head. Yeah, your Twister will do nothing. Yeah, there's no way that's taking out my substitute. Yep, we're good. Alright, keep lowering the speed. Quad resisted Leaf Storm, but it's the Razor special attack. Alright, more than half HP to go. Or less than half. Yeah, we're kind of relying on Icy Wind here. Not the worst thing in the world, but hey, that crit was clutch. Now, he's trying to take out my, what am I calling? No, my substitute faded, man. Too late. Too late, you foolish fool. And now your defenses are lowered. No, not the Jellicent. We totally needed the Jellicent in here. I think we lowered this thing's speed as much as we did. And now with your defenses dropped, just another mega kick for the road. Just in case he does go for Dragon's Ascent against you, that's a pretty decent one. To Dynamax, probably surviving even though you're at 75% HP or around there. Alright, one more good hit, you're done. And that should do it. Bye bye, Rayquaza. Come on, stay in the ball, Rayquaza. Ah, what am I kidding? Alright, are we shiny? Is any one of you shiny? No? Rayquaza? Ah. Alright, check the summary. Alright, good nature, though. Can't get him out of that. Alright, let's do another one. I just want to do a little bit of Battle Tower later on as well. Yeah, while we're here, right? Alright, invites others. Seems like we pressed the check button around the same time. And GB, I can't help but think that stands for goodbye. Maybe it does, maybe it doesn't, who knows. Alright, if nobody chooses Metang, I'm going after Metang. Probably Togetic would be a decent support option, too. Lower special attack, follow me for tanking a hit or two. Especially pair that if you get an Eviolite, Life Dew for healing, and then Fairy, cool. And then play rough for some decent Fairy stab, not bad. Alright, I'm going with Metang. The Frengar Clefairy would be even more support. Hey, we just have a bunch of pre-evolves on this team, dude. Let's see, we got two steel types, two fairy types, are all pre-evolutions. But we are the ultimate support clan, so that's what I like to call it. Let's go after Hawlucha. If I do get a shiny Hawlucha here, it's going to Scarlet Violet. Alright, wrestler, let's see what you got. Reflect. And everybody's in a status move, aren't they? Man, this person is taking their time. What are you doing? Just use Play Rough or something, or Life Dew to heal. Either that or you're not there, I don't know. Oh no, all of our special defenses have been lowered. It's kind of weird how Dark lowers special defense, but Ghost lowers defense. Feels like that should be the other way around for most moves, but whatever. Get your Swords Dance off, not bad. Let's get some support going. Alright, got the Reflect up so we take a little less damage. Aha, beat you to it. Alright, I'm just gonna keep using Zen Headbutt now. Though Thunder Punch is a viable. Oh, it's a Psycho Cut. Yeah, I get Psycho Cut now. It didn't really need it, but okay. I mean, I guess more accuracy in exchange for a little less power and no chance to flinch. Though a higher chance to crit is always cool too. Ooh, yeah, that's some good damage. Need that. Alright, the Salucha is down. One more good attack and we win. And down goes the wrestler. Alright, nobody wants to change their pokes. Okay, what are we gonna choose this time? Now we're up here, water, which is Whalemore, and I think rock is Tyrantrum. I'm gonna go water. Oh, they all want rock tap. Now we do have a substantial advantage against it, so you can't get mad at that, I suppose. Alright, you know what? Eh, because I haven't used it yet, why not? Alright, Metang getting the Pokeball and become something very big. Bigger than the moon itself. It might as well be a goddamn planet on its own. I used Dark and Dance, I don't like that boost. Or was that Scale Shot? That was a Pen Dungeon, I don't know. Alright, Defense Boost, that will mitigate that. See, Defense Race for your allies. Why can't Scarlet and Violet do something like that? No, it has to be individual. Now once the Beldum Lime comes back in Scarlet Violet, I want to run an Eviolite Metang at some point. I think I had an Eviolite Metang in this game even. Alright, we take that good. Not doing anything bad there. Alright, lowering your defenses, you fool! I will exploit your weakness right there. Look at that damage, delicious. Alright, that kills. And good game, Tyrantrum. I like Tyrantrum's typing of Rock Dragon, but it's not the best type combo. I mean, other type can touch steel types for even neutral, and it hits, what, only five other types were super effective? And those pesky steel types really do get in the way. And it doesn't really have many resistances either. I mean, you at least have a Rock type that doesn't die to, or at least doesn't get killed off easily by Water and Grass type moves, but then you also have a Dragon type that doesn't resist those. I mean, the cold resistance to fire is pretty useful, don't underestimate that. And I don't think I'm gonna use this guy. Can't even take advantage of its ability. And Loaded Dice doesn't exist yet, so no Rock Blast or Scale Shots there. No more Friend Guard boost. Nah, I'm keeping my Metang. Everybody's keeping their Pokemon. I think we're safe here. I'm just realizing how similar the rocks in this map kind of look. Alright, Slowking and Bronzong. Slowking. I'm just realizing how similar the rocks over here look to some of the Terastal rocks in Scarlet and Violet, so maybe they take a bit of a design trope from there. I didn't even notice we had a normal type option as well, but it doesn't matter. Alright, Slowking, hey, did you know in a future game you can make jokes, really, really bad jokes, but you can make them? Alright, you're not a physical attacker, so no point using Reflect, so just Thunder Punch. Man, Thunder Punch is so cool. It'll punch you first, and then lightning will strike down. That's how fast it is. Like, imagine screaming Thunder Punch, you punch someone, and they go, where's the thunder? Give it a second, bam! Hit him right there, that'd be so cool. I want somebody to animate that, I'd pay to animate that. Or have somebody animate it. That was his Generation 3 animation, where he just punch you first, then the lightning strikes down. Unlike his Gen 4 or 5 animation, where while it's punching you, the lightning is bursting. Alright, speed lowered. Not like it matters, you're a slow kick. You're slow for a reason. Seeing that it has Ice Punch, maybe it'll be a good time to use Reflect, but meh, don't think so. You could use Max Rockfall, dude. I don't see why you wouldn't use it. It would chip away at it. Plus, you get a free Special Defense buff. Yeah, at least you'd use it next turn. Heck, everybody besides the frickin' whatchamacallit, Togetic benefits from the Sandstorm in some way, so why not, right? And Slowking didn't even animate just now. That did not look right. Alright, you should use Max Rockfall now. Would be a really good time to use it. And Precursors to Chilly Reception, anybody? Well, not really, since this is still hail. It's before it changed to snow. But that'd still be a nice little Easter egg, maybe, or foreshadowing that no one would see coming. I think when I was in elementary school, back when Generation 4 was the latest generation, I always wanted snow to be a weather. I mean, finally got it, but hail's gone because of it. Dude, Max Rockfall, dude, what are you doing? Whatever. Would have gotten more damage out of it, too, if you did that. Alright, one more turn, and the Slowking is down. It's not even animating anymore. Come on, man. Real. Alright, the Dynamax is over. And magically teleported over there. I never knew about that Shuckle shirt, huh? Yeah, I learn something new every day. And he's eating a thing of curry. Man, I want to get me some curry, too. I have curry powder in my house. I just have yet to really make some chicken curry. I tried one time, but I put too many spices in it because I was trying to substitute them. Because I didn't have the right ingredients, nor did I have my own money to buy them at the time, so I didn't want to wait. But now that I do, I really should try making chicken curry again. Maybe I should eat it right here while playing this game, or Persona 5 or something, or another game that has High emphasis on curry. Alright, and here comes the big bad once again. Alright, no changing my mana, I'm good with what I have. Alright, the first thing we're gonna do is reflect, because the majority of its moves are physical attacks, so take advantage of it, why don't we? And then Meteor Mash for some attack boosts. Also, Rayquaza, I've come to bargain. Alright, the power to reflect your attacks is now mine in my hands. I should either let the Tyrantrum, Dynamax, or the Slowking. I think that's a better idea. Of course you're critty. Right, dude. I don't know who just flinched, but we're getting that reflect up. Sorry, hit the table. Ha! Clutch freeze. Not like it was needed, but clutch freeze. Alright, let's just start Meteor Mashing for attack buffs. Man, if only loaded dice existed in this game. Tyrantrum, you'd be a force to be reckoned with. Because I know that would be its competitive niche. And you probably have to run Rockhead. Well, nah, you don't really have to. You could always just do a strong job with, like, Fire Fang coverage or something. Or Poison Fang coverage, which I think Tyrantrum learns Poison Fang. I could be wrong. I think it learns it, yeah. It makes sense. It's good for those pesky fairy types, too. And Terra Poison if you really wanted to. Meteor Smash, Meteor Mash. Alright, pretty much. Yeah, nah, he's down this turn. Heh heh, can't do anything, as he's just creepily floating there. And you're done for, almost. Yeah, he stole my kill again. Even in this game, I can't get away with that. Alright, and in the ball you go. Dude, I already used 10 Ultra Balls in this episode alone. I don't know, man. I'll be running out of Ultra Balls really soon. Let me stop. And now while I wait for this long animation to play, I'm gonna drink me a little water. Alright, let's see what our shinies. Not Hawlucha, not Tyrantrum, not Slowking, and... Ah, no Rayquaza shiny either. Sad as it is. I'm gonna have to get rid of Yee for now, but we got a lot of Dianite ore. I was gonna check and see how much Dianite ore I have now. Would you like to keep the record? Yes, I would. Seventy-three of them, okay. wish we could transfer items in between generations too. I'm surprised we're 9 generations in, and we still have, and we still don't have the power to transfer items between games. Come on, why, man? That would be so useful. I could transfer ability capsules from Scarlet and Violet or vice versa, and ability patches and whatnot. I haven't wanted an ability, an item like ability patch since Generation 6 when ability capsules were a thing. I mean, it finally happened thanks to this DLC. Right as we waiting for people to come in here. Alright, here we are. And I'm at the top here, I get first pickings of the Pokemon. Alright, I'm gonna quit this thing and reload it in. Not enough people are coming in here. Let's try this again. Will somebody be in? Let's try again after Rayquaza. Maybe next one I'll do a little break from Rayquaza if it's not shiny. Alright, Aelia, spelled slightly differently, from a certain character from a certain game. I get some time for somebody to come on in here. The first few times it definitely loaded quite quickly. Alright, there we go. Now we have all 4 people. Alright, I'm definitely not choosing no Butterfree. I think Golurk might be the best choice here. Or... yeah, we're about to go against a Dragon-type Golurk's best. Also, I did not know that Lampin gets Skitter Smack. Strange, but okay. Should be able to learn Mystical Fire, it would make sense. The answer here should be obvious, the fire type. Though half of it seems weak to it, the other half is not. Well, and that's where we're going. Alright, Combusken. It's Scorching Sands, even though I cannot burn you. Rage Powder, Thunder Wave. Just cripple him. Alright, very, very good damage. We need some of that now. Alright, Scorching Sands will do a decent amount, though you are not a special attacker. I'm not gonna Dynamax, no need to. I could have done a Focus Punch strategy just now, I just realized. The move that nobody uses, though, it's a really cool move. Alright, down goes the Combusken. I just want to keep one of these Combuskens for when Indigo Disc comes out and the other starters come back. That would be really cool. And that speed boost Blaziken's gonna be a beast. No need for that. Alright, we have a Swampert, or whatever is in here, I can't tell. Eh, Swampert. Swampert's too cool. It's a miss. And it seems everybody else thinks the same. And that was a Heliolisk. Alright, Swampert, I can't wait for you to return in the DLC. I was going to catch you actually in preparation for that. You know what? Fuck it. I'm gonna go transfer you over there when Indigo Disc comes out. Now, let me try to Focus Punch. We're gonna get off this move, man. I know we can. Golurk is tightening its focus, and of course it missed. Alright, let's hope and pray it doesn't attack me. I'm just hoping. So we can get this attack off. Alright, next turn, your Max Geyser will do more damage, though. Be aware that its water moves will now be strengthened as well. No Earth Power against me? Okay, good sign, good sign. Yes, got my Focus Punch off. Big, big, big damage. That's what I like to see. Now, I'm gonna see if I can try to burn it. Alright, Max Geyser right now. Alright, no burn. Should've just went for the Focus Punch again. and because I like this move, let's do it. Though the anime did make this move quite good. Oh, well, make it look good. Just because it looks good doesn't mean it is good, I'm just saying. I can get my focus punch up. No, he attacked me. God damn it. Oh my lord, that damage. I lost my focus. I was focusing there, dude. This takes concentration, you know. You rude. Very rare rude Pokemon you are. At this turn, it should be dead anyways. And down you go. Yeah, I'll probably keep this specific marsh to our Swampert just for when Indigo Disc comes out. Assuming the Rayquaza we get isn't shiny. And I'll use it, and I'll swap out Golurk if nobody else is going to use it. Yeah, it's mine! Alright. And, oh wait, we got another thing to worry about. Alright, Auroras, Tauros, or Glalie Auroras. Probably gonna be the easiest one to deal with, and we get an item out of it. Alright, well, there's no grass type moves to worry about. I think Blunder Policy would be really good here. Why not? Double my speed when I miss an attack, and we do have Blizzard, so that pairs pretty well with it, I'd say. Is very good against Rayquaza, as you've seen in previous videos of mine. And because I haven't gotten the chance to yet, why don't we Dynamax? Alright, Swampert, my pal, grow to an absolutely gargantuan size. Alright, crippling it, we're looking good here. And poor Aurora with its weakness lighting typing. It can't get anything done with a garbage typing and very slow too. Just makes it really hard to use. Like, both Rock and Ice are really bad defensively. I mean, sure, Rock's got some useful resistances like Fire and Flying, but then it's got resistance to Normal and Poison. Kind of lackluster types offensively anyways. And then Ice, we all know that, and we haven't won resist to itself. I mean, at least it's a good counter for Ice types, I guess. Other Ice types. And let's raise the team's special defense while we're at it, why not? Get a little support in there. Oh yeah, that hurt him real bad. Yeah, that's gonna kill. Alright, down goes Auroras. I probably didn't even need to Dynamax, but it's nice to get that off anyways. I didn't want to use up my Blizzard, I'm saving that for Razzquaz. Alright, Rayquaza, I've come to bargain. An airlock is in effect, so no weather. Oh no, whatever will we do, anyways? Besides Twister, do you have any other special attacks? Ah, no point in using setup right now. Well, besides seeing if I can get my speed buff. Kinda wish you could get choiced items down here, but no. I guess I thought that'd be too broken. Should have used Body Slam, dude. Oh, that's why. And he got the Honor Boost. Huh, what a gamble. But he did it. That speed's already pretty lowered, but I get what he's doing. Alright, I hit the Blizzard. So no Blunder Policy Boost. This policy says right here, if I ever miss an attack, I get plus 2 speed. Yep, you're gonna get that max hailstorm. Yeah, max hailstorm right here. You know, if snow was in Generation 8, what would the max move be called? Probably G-Max Snow Squall, maybe? Or Max Snow Squall, I mean. Or Max Snow Globe, Max Snowstorm? I don't know. Maximum Blizzard. Max Blizzard Storm. Max Snow Squall sounds alright. Yep, lowers attack. Good. Actually, you know what? I realize something that the Dynamax mons can't do. That, whatamacallit? That Terramons could do. They can't take away their own stat drops or whatamacallit? Or status effects. I guess they added that in here because I thought, alright, let's bounce out a bit more. Or they added that in, Terra Raids. Because it's kind of easy to cripple the Dynamax mons by doing that. Especially with the effects of certain max moves like Max Wormwind. Or G-Max Befuddle. Now I'm kind of wishing I used Amnesia. Alright, can we at least miss a Blizzard? Probably not, I don't know. Alright, lowered attack. And yeah, we win. Bye-bye, Rayquaza. And now let us see if you're a shiny. Alright, in the Ultra Ball you go. Alright, now the moment of truth is here. Will they be shiny or will they not? Will they shine or will they be regular? Will they be common or will they be rare? Alright, Combuskins looking the same, Swampert's looking the same. No worse, and finally, Rayquaza. Still not shiny, oh boy. Oh well, is what it is. Alright, let me take the Swampert for when the Indigo Disc DLC comes out. Can't wait to transfer him. And we're not gonna do any nicknaming, I don't need to. In the box you go. And now let's take a break from shiny hunting Rayquaza for a bit. Let's just shiny hunt anything. Let's see what weird things we find. If it's one of the forces of nature, I'm transferring that right over to Scarlet and Violet after this. I I like how we all have the same picture. But the last from Sword and Shield was adorable. I like her design. Best of the last designs, in my opinion. Alright, if nobody chooses a cell girl, I'm going after that. Oh, great. Blossom's the best choice I've got, I guess, helping hand strats. Alright, what do we have here? It's a strong psychic type. Alright, we got a Swoobat. Or... can't tell, the Pseudo-Widow. Alright, we'll go after that. Ah, we're going after Swoobat. Everybody dictates the left. None of us can really hit this thing for good damage, can we? Should have chosen the grass to- not the grass one, the frickin' whatamacallit. Alright, maybe some- because we're mostly geared towards support here, so, eh, let's get a grassy terrain up. Thanks to Swoobat being fly type, it's not affected by that. I guess the Selgur is the best form of damage we have here, isn't it? Oh boy. Mulligan's dead. Sharply rose the speed. Oh no. Actually, I didn't know Simple worked with a Dynamax boost either. That is the first time I'm seeing that, and this game's been out for almost 4 years. And Swoobat was in the base game, might I add. Shit, that would have been a decently good niche, actually. Too bad it's gone with time. And Swoobat sucks, anyways. It really needs some sort of evolution. Let me give Acelagor a helping hand. Oh, good thing I did that. Just sharply raising your speed, go ahead. Actually, doesn't Simple expect stat drops as well? I think it does. I could be wrong, but I think it does. Yeah, it does. Okay. Nice little downside to it. That would definitely helps more than Nerds, I'd say. Thanks to your halved special attack, that doesn't do much, though it still does a sizable amount. Sadly, I don't like the amount of damage that does, but thankfully the Swoobat is gone. Swoobat being threatening for once? Ooh boy. And I think if I remember correctly, the shiny odds in Dynamax Adventures, if you catch all four of the Pokemon you're presented with, there's a 1 in 300 chance that at least one of them's gonna be shiny. And I did get shinies before. I once got a shiny, Rabombi here that I actually didn't except because I wanted Tapu Koko over it. But, whatever. I didn't know you could just get that and then get the Tapu Koko later, so I had to get that then. That simple beam. Man, I miss that move. Just trade over a simple beam to a Pokemon that has a weakness policy, maybe, or something else for that effect. Give it a Swords Dance, it'll get that plus three. It'll be so devastating. Alright, what is that? I can't tell. And that is a Piloswine. I want to go normal. Alright, we got supplies, man. Alright, we're not pre-evolves. Add leftovers. Oh, it's a Chinchino. That'll be coming back in Indigo Disc. Can't wait for that. Get those loaded dice tail slaps off, dude, with Technician. I always liked running Technician Life Orb with it, because, I mean, it scares you to hit at least twice, so why not, right? Try to power up a Solgor again. I'm just realizing how similar in color scheme both Alolan and Blossom are. Now that I see them side by side, I legitimately never noticed that before. If I were him, I would have acid sprayed first then. Bug buzzed? Definitely would have been a one-shot sweeping if that were the case. I could have prepared my leftovers with a grassy terrain now that I think about it as well. You know what other move I always liked running on Chinchino? Speaking of which, Tail Slap. But, Aqua Tail is always cool. I'm surprised we don't have an ability that boosts the power of Tail moves like Aqua Tail, Blitz Tail, Iron Tail, Tail Slap. Like, it's such a missed opportunity. That'd be really good ability for, like, things like Ambipom and Chinchino over here. I was running around a Terra Water Chinchino, specifically for those pesky rock types that it does have trouble hitting for neutral damage. And I'm glad it learns Aqua Tail, even though not many people run Aqua Tail. Chinchino. I think I have that strat in this game. With Life Orb? Either Life Orb or Muscle Band. Nobody uses Muscle Band, man. Justice for that item. Voice could be a decent niche as well. It is powered up by Technician. Could do something like that. It's just it's oh, now you use Acid Spray. Okay, whatever. Thank you for the Pollen Puff. Come to think about it, I could use Pollen Puff on Unova and Lilligan in Scarlet Violet. I wonder if Hisui and Lilligan gets it as well, because if it does, it would be very useful. It is faster. Alright, now that you did the smart move and used Acid Spray, you should bug but I should help hang in, and then you should bug buzz this turn. Yep, good. Nice Dynamaxing. Not like it was needed, you would have killed with bug buzz anyways, but yeah, whatever. I guess just to show off a little, right? Alright, Max Flitzer, bye, and now you're done. Somehow it didn't die from that. Whatever, whatever's the next move that it gets hit by, it ends it right there. Bye-bye. I might take Gentruno myself, honestly. Blossom just ain't cutting it for my liking. And maybe just like with the Swampert earlier, I think I should keep this one for Teal Mask DLC. Teal Mask. Indigo Disc DLC. Get these competitive threats going when all that is said and done. And it does get triple Axel. That would be useful. Much faster, and I can actually do some damage. So Technician triple Axel, man. And hopefully triple Axel returns in Scarlet and Violet's DLC as well. The second part of it. Terra Ice. That thing, delicious. Damage is Terra Ice Technician. Yeah, Life Orb that thing too. Man, they won't know what hit him. Let's see, there's Frostlass in that direction. Is that Slowking? What is that? That's Slowbro. Alright, I'm going flying. None of these are particularly good for us, I'll be honest. Alright, Gentruno, do it. Alright, I'm gonna start off with a light screen. Try to lower its special attacks. Alright, I'm not Dynamaxing. My max moves will literally do nothing to this thing, so no point in doing that. What are you laughing at, huh? Screw your pitiful laughter. Alright, little chip damage, nothing bad there. Yeah, acid spray, good move. I just want to use two acid sprays if I were him. Alright, light screen, lower them, special attacks. Why would you just waste a turn, why don't you? Okay. And now I just have to hit you with lackluster triple axles, and it's a little sad. Alright, using acid spray a second time there, good move, I'd say. And I missed. I attack and I miss. I attack and I miss. Alright, but while we're sitting down here, whatever that psychic type legendary might be up there, it could be many things. We could see... Ooh, clutch special defense drop. We could see... Solgaleo, Lunala... Latios or Latias, that's possible. If it's Latias, I think I might just catch it right then and there. Probably transfer that over to BDSP or something. Is that all of them? It could be Tapu Lele, and that's a possibility. I think I already caught my Tapu Lele in this game. That might be all the psychic. It could be Mewtwo as well, that's a possibility. One of the Light Guardians. And I think that's about it. It should be the rest of them. So you're not getting the Pixie Melons like Celebi or Mew or Victini down here. Which Victini is in this DLC if I remember correctly. I hope it gets added to Scarlet and Violet eventually. Yeah, yeah, I got an attack off. Besides that light screen, I literally can't do shit to this thing. Nice, I hit all three though. Oh no. Ah, even through the light screen, that does so much. Max over. Yeah, that might kill actually, because of the minus 6 special defense they have. Goodbye, Frostlass. Probably behooves him since we're about to go against the psychic type to keep the Assault Girl. Actually, Necrozma could show up too, that's a possibility. I don't think. Can you shout out Necrozma down here? I think you can, I don't remember. I'm good without it. We do not need it. All right, berries for healing. I still got my leftovers. That's awesome. Now, what psychic type will show up today? And Cresselia, I completely forgot about it, which I think I already found Cresselia in the save file. And if I didn't, I've already got a shiny Cresselia in Scarlet Violet, so... I mean, if I didn't already catch it, then I'm definitely gonna catch this one for more of them. I mean, hey, more Cresselias, right? For my VGC teams, Cresselia's pretty much the ultimate VGC mon, in my opinion. Get all them support moves, thanks to Terra, pairing it with leftovers. Levitate. You could run Terra Steel to give it more resistances, Terra Poison to not have to worry about Toxic, and only boot Psychic types, Terra Electric to have literally no weaknesses, Terra Fire if you want to guess a bit more offense on it. That's all you can do. Thanks to that special attack drop, and now the light screen, your special attacks aren't going to do anything. I think we'll just Tail Slap next turn. And mind you, this is before Cresselia was nerfed. It was supposed to be a counterpart to Darkrai at one point as well. So, it's kind of... Well, I get why they lowered its stats, but then they'd have to lower Darkrai's stats too for that to even be fair. That damage you did to me was worthless, kind of. By one point, never mind. Alright, Tail Slap, how many of these can we hit? I feel like I'm the one contributing the least here, mainly just because of how weak my attacks are, at least to this thing's defenses. I still contributed something thanks to that light screen. If I had a helping hand, that'd be really good, but no, instead we get Echoed Voice. Yeah, I'm pretty sure Chichino does get helping hand, right? Yeah, it could be a decent support mon, especially if it gets Follow Me. That'd make a lot of sense if it does. That's gonna do some damage. Yeah, look at that. Alright, it's probably gonna start getting more desperate now. Yep, there it is. Oh no, my stat buffs. The Lilligan trainer's definitely seething from that one. Max Mindstorm, that will do nothing. Okay, never mind, it did something. It's special for special attack, I mean, it's still lowered, right? Unless it got rid of that too? Yeah, no, judging by that damage, there's no way. And I miss. Of course I do. I want check info. Yeah, it gets rid of... Okay, never mind what I said earlier about them not being able to take away their own stat debuffs. They can do that. It just wasn't noticeable because the game doesn't really tell you that. Whatever. Thank the Lord for that speed stat. Yep, I already caught it. Alright, no Cresselia. Do we have a shiny here? We do not, but I'm gonna keep this Shinchino. No thanks. Alright, now I would like to go to the restroom for a little bit. I will be RB. Alright, we are back, so let us do some more of these. Let's go after Rayquaza again. Alright, we're just waiting for one more person. There's gotta be somebody else here. Got the fourth person. Let's start the journey. Alright, I get first picks. And we're going as Chevalier. Alright, we're starting with Electric Psychic. On Raichu? I'm just kidding. Alright, let's see here. That looks like a Luxray and a Kadabra. Let's go after that. Low defenses, it should be easy to take out. And everybody wants the Luxray. Okay, then. Luxray, show me what you got. Alright, we can Dynamax right here, but I don't think it's needed. Drill Run. Got the perfect move just for you. I really do hope Escavalier comes back in the Scarlet Violet DLC, but I don't think that's gonna happen either. Because, I mean, Terra Water would be really good for those pesky fire types that it has trouble with. I mean, hey, if Scizor works with Terra Fire, or Terra Water, I mean, then Escavalier definitely should as well. And does anybody else know about that dex entry of Escavalier being able to... I missed. Of Escavalier doing, being able to fly at very high speeds despite a speed stat only being base 20. It's a little embarrassing that you're able to move that fast, but you have a base 20 speed stat. Your base speed stat is the same as frickin' Ferrothorn. And Quagsire, which actually, no, Quagsire is base 35. Clawdsire, that's right. Before the Clawd existed. Alright, attack buff will definitely be useful. Alright, X, a little chip damage. Can this hit? Yes, it will. Oh yeah, good damage. Alright, we should be able to take out Luxray this turn. Now, assuming all the chips align correctly. I hope he gives us another attack buff. Yeah, Drill Run, and if we crit. Drill Run can one-shot- well, it's not a one-shot, obviously, you're not at full HP. But this will be an easy KO as soon as the Magmar Trainer makes up his mind for what he wants to do. There we go. Max Knuckle, and now Drill Run should one-shot as long as it hits. Oh, I keep saying one-shot, it's not a one-shot. There's no way Dusclops is killing from there. No, my stat buffs, man, that's just rude. Oh, that's not the best start to the Dynamax adventure. At least this hits. Bye-bye. And get in the Ultra Ball. Alright, I'm keeping us Cavalier, we do not need it. Alright, that's a Musharna. I think that's a Mantine. And, That's an orbital. Let's go after orbital. The team probably can best handle that. And we're going after the Musharna, alright. This team can handle Musharna decently well. Especially if that Luxray has a Dark-type move. It probably doesn't, but if it does, it would work. Still be nice if Luxray had Strong Jaw, though, it would make sense. I mean, Luxray's already in Scarlet and Violet, there's no way they're changing that ability for it. Definitely be better than Rivalry, I'll tell you that much. I mean, again, if Shiftry of all things can get an ability change, man, Luxray should too. And Forewarn, a very useless ability that I'm glad hasn't been seen in a very long time. Even though I think Hypno has it in Scarlet and Violet, but who cares. And how many of these Fury Cutters can we hit? And all I need is 3 Fury Cutters for it to be at maximum power. Technically 2 Fury Cutters. And then the third one will be at base 160. After stab, that's 160. Stab is 60. Right? Yeah. 60 from stab. And for that one, it's 30. Yeah. This should be base 120 and... No, right? Now, what? Yeah, 120 power is right. Now, the 160 would be 240. Yeah, the next one's gonna hurt like a train. And no need to Dynamax. I don't need that. Man, we don't. What am I doing? We don't need that garbage gimmick. We got Fury Cutter. Can you survive that? Yes. I get the final hit. Oh, who cares about your yawn? Your yawns aren't contagious in this world. And goodbye. Shiny Musharna is... Nah, okay. Kind of wish to change the color of its little dream mist that's coming out of its head. But no. Like, Musharna is kind of the Hypno of Generation 5. It's still better than Hypno, I don't care. Pretty tanky, too. You can run this policy on like a trick with the team. If Musharna ever comes back in Scarlet and Violet, definitely want to use that. I mean, I know Reuniclus definitely is, so I'm definitely using that bad boy. Maybe even will leave you like Terra Steel. Alright, no need to change. Though my moveset can't really do anything to Rayquaza, and that's a bit of a problem. You just got that Musharna, dude. What are you changing your mind for? Hey, you got garbage. Got literal garbage. Alright, Cramorant or... I can't tell what that dank type is. I want to say maybe Malamar? Let's go that way. Alright, we're hitting the Cramorant then. And again, none of my moves do anything to it. Why does our moveset just gets walled by flying types? Or flying types that resist water moves. Either other water types, or grass type too, there's that. Well, Fury Cutter would be neutral at that point. Yeah, I've seen fan-made Gigantamax Cramorants that had like a Wailord in their mouth. That would have been super cool to see, but no. Instead, we get nothing for Cramorants. Would have been perfect too, a good candidate. Of G-Max. Not entirely sure which G-Max move would do, maybe lower attack by 2 stages? I don't know. And paralyze too? I don't know. And you're poisoned. No gulp missile for you, you fool. Because dive ain't supposed to work like that. Oh, at least I'm doing defense drop? Good. Real nice turn, even though Kraven's a bit of a weak boy. I might catch this one, trust of this one over Scarlet Violet as well. Should I? I don't know, just to trade it with people. Venom Dredge is such a niche-ish move. I mean, it pairs well with Toxic Spikes, I suppose. But it's just such a status-y move. That's pretty much it. Which, actually, I don't think Venom Dredge is in Scarlet Violet. Would have worked really well with the Loyal 3. That just came out at the time of me making this video. I kind of want to see how dropped your stats are. Plus 2 special defense, though, while everything else is lowered by at least one stage. Can't underestimate that, right? And down you go, you bird. And now down you go. Alright, next is Rayquaza. Alright, everybody should be nice and healed. Yes, to full. Alright, Rayquaza, I've come to bargain. I think I should use Taunt on it just in case it tries to get any dragon dances off. That was a miss. Now all I can really do is try to fish for some defense drops. Can that poison? No. I can Dynamax, but I wouldn't be, it wouldn't be very useful for me to do so. Save that for somebody else, I'd say. I've been killed! Despite my actual decent defenses. Well, we only have 2 lives left. Alright, poisoned. Clutch. Now they can start venom drenching. I think that was from Dragon's Descent as well. Alright, now what effect do I give when I cheer? That did some sizable damage to it, then in exchange we'll have 1 life to go. Alright, put him to sleep. Actually, he's poisoned already. We can't do that. Alright, sizable poison damage. We're good, we're good. Did the taunt wear off? The game hasn't told me yet. Probably not. I'm gonna see it this turn if taunt is still in effect. Nope, it ain't in effect no more, and its speed is raised while special attack has not been lowered. Now, Chisel will really get you going! Alright, I think that's exactly what we need to raise our resistance to physical attacks. No! Luxray's about to die. Now, that ain't doing anything to me. That's cool. And my Razor Shell sadly won't do enough to it. Lower its defense would be nice, but I don't think so. Yeah, I don't think the poison's killing. It's so close, man. Anyone have a priority move? No, probably not. There's no way. As long as he doesn't attack Luxray, I think we win. There is a chance here. Oh, you son of a... Fuck you. No! Was blown out of the den. Oh well. Alright, no shiny, no shiny. Yeah, should I keep it? Nah, I don't wanna. Never mind, I'm changing my mind. Alright, let's try this again. Alright, and did you know again? Alright, we got Exeggutor and Zarina. Alright, we're going Exeggutor. Eggs Eater, I'm calling it that now. Did you know, come forth? Alright, nobody has an ability. Well, thanks for crippling me, dude. I kinda need Technician, you know. I wouldn't like imitating Weezing's voice in the anime. I can't be the only one. It's a pretty funny voice. Dude, Jesus Christ, I almost got killed. Alright, at least that was all out of the way. That crit probably mattered in killing us. Alright, in the ball you go. I'm gonna see if everybody else is changing their mind. Cause I might need to change mine just so, you know, I have something that's at full HP. Yeah, we're changing. Not that good against Razzlequest, but I don't want to lose a life, so there's that. Alright, Grudence and Fracture. Fracture, show me what you've got this time. Alright, let's just Psycho Cut. Probably the best thing we can do. And whilst we wait for this, I want to see if Exeggutor is going to be in Scarlet Violet. I'll probably keep this one if that's the case. Oh, screw you. I'm dead. Just go for the button type move, alright. The AI's got a mind now, everybody. Alright, all I can do now is cheer. Big sad for me, I suppose. Hey, Exeggutor is coming back in Indigo Disc. Well, guess I know which Pokemon I'm keeping if the requisite is not shiny. always thought that rocks resist bug, but that bug already has too many types of resistance. There's no point in that. Alright, now I'm gonna keep Exeggutor, no point in changing it. Actually, it's a bit of a risk. Fuck it. Just because I don't want to be weak to flying. At least I'll be able to hit the Rayquaza back for super effective. Alright. Alolan Raichu. Actually, I could keep that and transfer that over to Scarlet Violet, so I'm gonna pick this. I'll screw the Exeggutor, I suppose. And we get an item out of it, too. Exazors. I doubt it has any physical moves, so Breaking Swipe ain't gonna be too useful. Oh, that thing doesn't have Lightning Rod, does it? Oh my god, piss off, dude. How did that hit so hard? And a Surge Surfer ability activates. I should make an electric terrain team at some point, especially after Indigo Disc comes out. At least we took you out in one turn. Good lord. Did we all have a super effective move for this thing? And I'm choosing Alolan Raichu over Exeggutor just because it's rarer. To transform as SV. Good. Alright, now what items will you have? I think, actually, let's take advantage of the weakness policy. This policy says here, if I get slapped with a dragon type move, I get +2 attack and +2 special attack. Also, Rayquaza, I've come to bargain once again, and we will keep bargaining until we get your shiny form. And we can Dynamax right away. So that's exactly what we're gonna do. Alright, just take the Dragon Tip, it's a little bit better as well. Alright, nice meaty HP stat. We should be able to take whatever dragon move you have to throw at us. Not that move, since that is not a Dragon-type move. Alright, good job lowering your own stats. Max Wormwood! Alright, slow him down. We're looking real good with this. Kinda hoping you go for Twister. And, wow, that should not have missed. Yeah, whatever, I've already lowered your attack. If the same thing happens this turn, we should win. You also have lowered speed, so we're more likely to get the jump on you. Alright, lower that attack. Uh-oh. Please hit me with that. Yes! You just oh my god. Calm down, dude. But anyways, you just activated my trap card. Alright, at least the plus one attack will do just fine. No, not the Weezing. The neutralizing gas wore off. Alright, Rock Tomb, lower its speed even further. Yeah, next turn we pretty much win. All I need is that last Max Wormwood off, and we're good. Thanks to your speed drive, yeah, no, we win in this. And let's just make sure that speed is still dropped. Yeah, wow, look at all them stat drops. And we win. Yes, give us cheers. What is our boost? Dynamax. Oh, yeah, right. Light screen. Why would you extreme speed? On the rock type of all things. Alright, you're just AI's throwing. And down you go. And 754 Ultra Balls, now 753. That's Ultra Necrozma's base stats owner. Yeah, like anybody remembers Ultra Necrozma. From the one game it showed up in, it'll probably never show up again. Unless they make a new method for it to show up, I don't know. Kinda can't bring up the Ultra Beast and Necrozma in one order of the Light Trio without some weird Ultra Wormhole shenanigans going on anyways, so it wouldn't make sense otherwise why they'd even be here. Alright, that's keeping Exeggazor. Raichu ain't shiny. And no shiny here. Alright, we're gonna keep the Alolan Raichu since it is rare. No nickname. It's going right over to Scarlet Violet after this. Yeah, let's put that in the records. And what can we find this time? Anything will be good. Seven Acts On? What type of name is that? Eh, whatever, it doesn't matter. I literally just used this fracture too. How? What a coincidence, right? Alright, Wailmer, obviously, and Charmeleon. Alright, Charmeleon. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is lower its attack with the Breaking Swipe attack. Dude, you're a water type. Just use your water type move. Actually, a smart move on his part. Nice prediction. Never mind what I just said before. And that was likely out of Dragon Pulse as well. Alright, that's the damage we need. Alright, just use an outrage. No point in doing anything else. Yeah, your Endure is totally gonna work, dude. Yeah, but just stalled out another turn, that's all you did was delay the inevitable. Why would you use... I don't see why you did that. Just attack, he's got 1 HP left. Alright, and in the Ultra Ball you go. Alright, don't need it. Alright, Skarmory, Lycanroc, and all. No, it's an Octillery. Yeah, let's go after the Rock type one. I think the team best handles that. Alright, Lycan boy, we're gonna take you down. Alright, Reckon Swipe to immediately cripple you. We do not want you being at full power here. I wasn't paying attention. What legendary are we going up against since we didn't pick Rayquaza again? So I'd have a little change of pace again. Oh, that one's going to hurt. Alright, and outrage to finish this. And down you go. still think midnight or midday like in rock should be rock normal. The midnight form rock dark and the dusk form rock fighting. Really dumb how Terrakion is still the only that's a dark fighting for rock fighting, excuse me. Really funny how Terrakion is still the only rock fighting type we've ever had. Just doesn't make much sense to me. Maybe I'll change to Lycanroc so we can have a decent support move. Yeah, why not? And Howl. Alright, our only choices are, it looks like, no, camera update in this game. Vespiquen will have to be the right option. That might be Hippowdon, maybe? It's hard to tell from here. Oh, we get an item, too. I'm not gonna Dynamax. There are better Dynamaxers here. Look at that, half HP already. Alright, just in case you have any physical attacks you might throw our way. Ah, you missed. Worst turn ever for an enemy. Catch the Vespiquen. If it were shiny, that would make it pretty useful. I mean, it would have been rare if it were a shiny female as a Combi, but how many people have actually gotten a shiny female Combi, huh? Alright, flying to- oh wait, we are against Rayquaza again, aren't we? Oh, I can't use Focus Sash. I could give my moves a chance to miss. Yeah, Bright Powder. A sack of Bright Powder that uses a smoke screen. I think that's how Bright Powder would be used, theoretically be used by the Pokemon. No, I chose a random thing, right? It'd be funny if it is Rayquaza again. If it's Tornadus, though, and I haven't caught that yet, no, I might have caught Tornadus in this copy. I don't remember if I did or not. It is my boy Tornadus, okay. If I catch it, I'm catching it here, and it's going to Scarlet Violet. Do need a new Tornadus, after all. I got a plan with these ones. That's all your attack. And of course the Stone Edge missed. That's not good. Ah, oh boy. Not Icy Wind, and that hit me somehow, despite my Bright Powder. solar power. Alright, all I can do is cheer from the sidelines. Oh boy. That actually looks pretty cool coming out of the palm of his hand. And then he gets a speed boost, so that's not good. Half HP now. Hurricane in the sun. Bullshit. And a crit. Wow, that's garbage. Mind you, Hurricane is 50% accurate in the sun, and that's not an MJTV joke, that's an actual thing. I think you should have used that before. That missed me, I guess. Alright, if Flakrock could get at least one Stone Edge next turn, we can win this. No, we've only got one shot at this. Alright, let's try Outrage. Man, double cheer, huh? Alright, I guess the heals will do. Give us a light screen. Yes, ask it, you shall receive. Alright, my outrage will kill from that range. That's okay, I'm fine with that. Now you miss a frickin' hurricane. Okay. And down you go. That was a difficult one. I didn't catch tornadoes yet. Well, guess we're catching it. I'm gonna transfer it over to Scarlet Violet. Do I have any other Pokeball I could use on it? Yeah, let's just use Ultra Ball. No point in shiny hunting tornadoes, it's not even all that good. I know I already caught Landorus on the save file, though. Because I am planning on making a new VGC team in Scarlet Violet with tornadoes, so this is perfect. But I like using its Therian form as well, but Assault Vest, U-turn with a Regenerator? Pretty damn good, might I add. And then knock off for utility, getting rid of people's items. Alright, not shiny, not shiny. Good. Alright, we're keeping you. You know, what nature do you have? Yeah, Prankster. Oh, well, Prankster's its ability. I could always run Terra Fire with Heat Wave, but I got another idea for you. Yes, take Tornadus with me. Alright, we don't need a I can nickname it later. Off screen, I'll probably do that. Now let's go after... Now let's just do another anything is fine. Screw Rayquaza. If y'all want me to try Shun Hunt and Rayquaza, I can always do that. Just let me know if you're on Twitch or YouTube, depending. Okay, who's gonna use Imposter Ditto? Who has to use the Among Us meme, hmm? I almost want to use this Ditto just for fun. I doubt anybody's choosing it, though. Don't worry, Basculin, you get an evolution in the future, I promise. And as I say that, they choose Basculin. Actually, no, you're gonna end up weakening Basculin. Yep, just for fun, we're doing Ditto. It's just like Among Us, everybody. Oh my god. And I'm cringing on my own joke. That was awful. It's the Psychic Tap. I'm hoping it isn't Cresselia. Alright, Lampent. Or, what's his face, that Pessimian. Yeah, I'll go after Lampent. Alright, Ditto's turned into that Lampent. Oh my god, it's just like a... I'm not making that joke. Imposter, I forgot, I think it was in Scarlet and Violet where Imposter spelled Impostor for some reason? I don't know. Well, Trick Room's cool, I guess. Yeah, let's just lower its special attack. Too bad it's a quad-resisted move, so I ain't gonna do anything. Be nice if I had a ghost move, but no. Too cool for that, apparently. Lower his defense. Even with the special attack drop, that still does a lot. I'm hoping this Lampent ends up being shiny. That'd be really cool. And, you know, because Ditto kinda sucks, I'm gonna change to Lampent. Assuming nobody else does. Also, the Kling's name, and thanks for taking that away from me, dude. Probably did that just try to keep me with the Ditto. Alright, that looks like a Munchlax? Yeah. And then there's Tyrantrum. I'll give us some... Okay. Going against Rhydan. Or Rhydon't. That's a better Rhydon junk than a certain other one I know. I will not say it here. And hopefully nobody else does either. And now that I said that, everybody's gonna say it, didn't they? Alright, hopefully we have at least a decent ground type move we can use. And yes, we do. Masculine, show them your power. The fish with teeth. His masculine slightly based on a, partially I should say, based on a piranha. Silkscorn does look like a weird piranha. Thank the Lord for Vascular Legion later on. Seriously, this thing is so under. Oh man, at least half that damage done is really good. Can't get mad at that. It's already pretty slow, but now I'll be faster than Rhydon. That's pretty cool. Kinda miss running Eviolite Rhydons. I actually had one of those back in the 3DS games. Also, Lampert just instantly died. And that's what you get for stealing Lampet from me, you fool! Like, I remember having a Rhydon, I think it had the Rocket ability, it was shiny. And I had it with Eviolite because I had gotten it off of GTS, or the Global Trade Station, back in the Generation 6 games. And it had a Drill Run, Fire Fang, Ice Fang, Thunder Fang. I think max HP, max attack was its stats. Yeah, we're gonna need Rhydon for this. You quit trying to take my freaking Pokemon, dude? What's wrong with you? Dude, screw you. Dude, someone clearly wants to be stuck with Ditto. Jesus. Now let's see, Scyther. That is a Thievul. That sucks. And Pangoro. Wait a minute, I'm gonna be weak to my Scyther. It doesn't matter. Either way, if we chose Scyther or Pangoro, it wouldn't matter. Alright, Wing Attack, Technician boosted likely, that'd be cool. Freeze him or something. Nope, no freeze. Okay. Blaze kick to the face. Look at that damage. Unless this guy tried to take Scyther too. And this will be really good against that Psychic type Legendary. Oh my, fuck off. That's the third time that's happened in a row. Man, it's almost like the game wants to be stuck with Dead Air. Alright, game, you'll have what you want to have. For the memes, man. Ditto all the way for the memes. It's a Mewtwo, which I already got my Mewtwo in this game, so don't think we're gonna get that. Be cool if Mewtwo has Shadow Ball, though. Well, technically that means we have a Legendary on our side. That's pretty cool. It would probably be better if one of the other Pokemon uses Dynamax, probably the Scyther. Get a good Bug-type move off, lower its special attack, all that stuff. And finally, a game where Mewtwo actually looks halfway decent. A lot of people prefer how it looks in Smash. Oh my god. In Smash Ultimates. So at least it looks alright in this game, and then even though it's just a 3DS model, we already know all that. Common knowledge. But still, I'm not a fan of the way it looks in Scarlet Violet. It just looks anorexic, like he just needs to eat something. Recover! Better yet, let's try to get rid of that, whatchamacallit, Blizzard. Yeah, that didn't do anything. Yeah, I just used Disable right then and there. Oh yeah, but you still have your max move. Okay. Now the Scyther's dead. Well, you know what that means. At least I've never missed Blizzards now. Alright, Rhydon is back again. At least it can't use Blizzard for itself, but that still did quite a sizable amount of damage. Let's hope that's a heal cheer. That'd be really cool. Unlike an SB, you can't choose that here. Oh, piss right off. You're just gonna heal. Look how much. Okay, real. Ha! Suck on that. Okay, never mind. Alright, Blizz. Oh, wait. I've been pressure stalled. Dude, piss off with the recovers. Gotta keep using that same move over and over again, don't ya? Why has nobody used Scary Face before? Gee, I can Dynamax now. I totally want to do that. Nah, I don't need to. I'm gonna recover. No, not Rhydon. He's dead. Oh well. Yeah, that's fine. Nobody cares about you anyways, Mewtwo. Now, what do we have here? At least one of these guys are shiny. No shiny Limpins, no shiny Rhydon, and no shiny Scyther. Oh well. No, I'm not gonna erase him. Alright, let's try one last time against Rayquaza, and if we don't find it, well, that'll be the end of this video. But don't go yet. If you've enjoyed what you've seen thus far, leave a like, comment, subscribe, and follow depending on which platform you're watching on. Plus, video is sponsored by the wonderful people at Dovey. Have you ever needed a little more energy for your gaming needs or just whatever you happen to be doing? Well, worry not anymore. With this wonderful 10% discount in the link in the description below, you could get yourself a wonderful 10% discount on your wonderful energy drink order by the lovely people at Dovey. Thank you for those people for sponsoring me, and let us continue this final Dynamax adventure. Just be ready and go. Yeah, let's have a change of pace. Alright, we're going after Altaria. Alright, Clefairy, we're gonna show you that you're the strongest Pokemon ever. I literally can't do jack to this thing. Alright, reflect. Seriously, why does Absol get Blizzard? I guess it's kind of based around how it's able to predict disasters, and I guess Blizzards are considered a disaster? I don't know. In case anybody takes damage, why don't we do this? Trying to think, I should have just went with Chinchino. And down goes Altaria. Eh, why not? Swap it out. Alright, for once the game isn't screwing me over. Aurora's gotta go for the Aurora. The Aurora Borealis against the Dragon. Auroraville's the closest thing we ever have to an actual Aurora Borealis in this game. Or in any Pokemon game, for that matter. If Auroraville didn't exist, I'd always ask for an Aurora Veil, like a move based on Aurora Borealis's. I guess that should be our kind of lackluster question of the day, but I guess not. Have you ever seen an Aurora Borealis, and if so, what was your experience on it? You like it or not? Well, I've never seen one personally myself, but it's a nice sight to behold whenever it does happen either in real life or in fiction. Alright, anyways, and I went after this thing, okay. Alright, likely we'll try to body slam me, so why don't we try to take those hits? I do not appreciate being Thunder Wave, sir. Alright, I can Dynamax if I want to, but I don't think there's much of a use to it. And just Dragon Pulse, it's stronger. Stab. We need that stab. No more Thunder. Why did you use Thunder Wave on me twice? Whatever, it doesn't matter. Now, if I can get my attack off Aurora's is down. Not really. It doesn't matter. Alright, see win. And if nobody's taking Aurora's, I will, because it's very good for Rayquaza. As long as we don't go up against any steel or fighting types, we're good. Am I still paralyzed even into the next round? I've never noticed that before either. You learn something new about these games sometimes. Alright, perfect. That will be very good for the Rayquaza. Alright, none of the types that I fear are up here. Let's go after that electric one. This team handles electric types pretty well, I'd say. Yep, and it seems everybody else thinks the same. Leftovers. Don't see why you chose a Lepiberry, but whatever. If that's your option, that's your option. Because I doubt you're going to run out of PP at any point during this fight. Faggus for Blizzard? That might be why. Stunfisk. Even better. Oh yeah, Dynamax Stunfisk's cry is really weird. Kind of sounds like a car skidding. Ah, no, it's strange. Alright, just body slam. Oh, that's gonna hurt. Not as badly as I thought, but it still did some damage. Ground tap. Again. Oh, they've been ground tap. What am I talking about? In the ground, just much larger. Max Quake? Kind of like the illusion that they're still, like, they're already in the ground, so they're not going to shrink much. Unlike literally any other Pokemon. Max Lightning, take the attack. And Body Slam one last time, you're done. Still way better than Wood Trio or Alolan Dugtrio will ever be. It's almost like they make forms of Dugtrio just bad on purpose sometimes, I swear. Somebody at Game Freak don't really like them too much, do they? And I think of all the regional forms, Galarian Stunfisk might be the most forgettable one. I mean, despite its really cool typing of Steel Ground, it's outclassed wholly by every other Ground Steel type in Steelix, Excadrill, and Iron Treads now. So why would you use Galarian Stunfisk over one of those three, you know? When they're all better in pretty much every way. Aside from the Mimicry ability, I guess, but that requires terrain to be used, and do you really want to change your type to a terrain you've already been? Like, and any Pokemon that can set up those terrains, you've already got that type, so why would you need that type overlap for a mediocre Mon, right? And the signature move, Snaptrap. It's a Grass-type move, not a Steel or a Ground-type move. It would have made more sense if it were a Steel-type move, but no, it's just not. And regional variants are a very, very cool thing, but easily Galarian Stunfisk is the most forgettable one, of all of them. Alright, Rayquaza, I've come to bargain. Probably the last time you hear me say that for a while. Alright, let's hope Rayquaza is shiny one final time. Oh, we gotta beat it first, that is. I think I should just cripple it with Thunder Wave. Actually, I can Dynamax right away. I think we should do that. Yeah, I'm gonna Dynamax it. I'm probably the best one for Dynamax right now. Aurora, show them your strength! Show them that you're not the worst fossil Pokemon. You can do it. The best Jodon probably is, from a competitive standpoint. For many reasons, despite how defensive it's trying to be. And it's good utility moves to just instant one-hit KO, alright. Well, that definitely was an instant one-hit KO, they were not a full HP, but who cares. Alright, Blizzard does huge damage. Alright, already nearly dead, just one more turn and yeah, you're screwed, Rayquaza. A good ice type just completely eviscerates him. That's why it's probably one of the easiest of all the Dynamax raids. Despite being the literal god of the sky. And Leftover's coming in clutch for some extra HP. It's more like I'm healing back maybe 1/32nd of an HP because of that, but yeah, whatever. You know, it's not exactly double HP with these Dynamax ones specifically, but whatevs. We already won, so we're good. Cheer up, cheer us on all the way. Brutal swing. That's okay, we're fine. Oh no, the storm grows even stronger. Oh yeah, no weather. Because of airlock, the weather effects are not active. Doesn't matter, we got this. Goodbye. Speaking of which, I've also got a new VGC team in mind, using Ogre Pond, which I want to go make that in Showdown after this video to go test it out and whatnot. Besides the other VGC team that I made that I'm almost done constructing. Yeah, I might even just test both of them out on that in the same video. It depends. Probably should think of a new team name for them as well. Alright, no Shiny Altaria, no Shiny Auroras. No Shiny Stunfisk, and now, for the last time we do this, unless the people want it again, is the Rayquaza Shiny. 3, 2, 1. It is not, sadly. How sad. Alright, not gonna bring anything home, it looks like. Yes, I'll save that for the record in case I ever decide to come back here. Cool, and I want to see how many Dino Doors I have. 126, alright. Alright, well, I think that shall be it. Let me just check my Pokemon box. Just seeing the things that we caught along the way. Now, there's the Tornadus I was talking about before. Give it a minus defense. Nature, which I don't think is that good. Minus attack will do just fine, honestly. Man, bring back Vanilluxe and Scarlet and Violet. Hashtag justice for Vanilluxe. Y'all know I actually do really like Vanilluxe quite a bit. Maybe I'll transfer the Sneasel over to Scarlet and Violet, but for now, you stay here. I'm trying to see where that Tornadus is that I just caught. It's somewhere around here. We'll find it eventually. Oh, here it is. Alright, what are your... Alright, just need HP and speed. Not bad. Okay, just wanted to check that out. Alright, and let us save real quick. First time I've clicked that in almost a year. But anyways, I believe that'll be it for the sub special. If you want the 350 sub special, do support me on YouTube. We are pretty close to 350 subs on there anyways. But anyways, if you all enjoyed this and you want to see more, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, and follow. Hit one of the videos you see on screen now if you're on YouTube, and that bell button for more. Once again, video is sponsored by the wonderful people at W. Hit the link in the description below, use the code provided to get a 10% discount on your wonderful energy drink order. Anyways, thank you everybody for watching, and see you next time. Have a night, have a terrific day.